Hello and welcome to this quick tutorial for Mix & Max add-on for Blender. In this tutorial I will show you the basics. So I'll add two materials to Blender, make a mix and connect them to the principled BSDF. In this example model we have only one material. If you have more materials, make sure that you have only one, and for each part that needs a different material, or even for each spot that needs a different material, you need to make a color ID. So a color ID is something like this, where every part has a different color. I can show you what it looks like here. So here you can see that every part that has a different material has a different color. It's also possible to have different materials on one object, as you can see here. So this is one object with two materials. Just add a different color and we can mask it out later on. Okay, we have only two materials here. This is for a later tutorial and the basic material in Blender. Let's get rid of this part and let's add some materials from the Quixel bridge. You can use your own materials or from another source than Quixel. These are very good as an example, so we'll use these. Let's add an aluminium and a dirty metal sheet here. Let's go back to Blender again and let's go to the aluminium material here. So here the node setup Quixel gives you for the aluminium. It looks pretty easy, but if you get a lot of these materials, some even have more nodes, and put them together and mix them, it will get pretty messy and it's hard to find what to connect to what. So that's why I made these mix groups. So convert to group, you get this mix group. So everything else is just to show you how it looks on the model here. But this mix group is what we'll use later on. We'll do the same for dirty metal sheet, convert to group, and here we have a group for that as well. It already has a fake user, so you can't throw it away by accident. And let's go to the default material here, and let's add these to a new made group. So Shift A, group aluminium, and Shift A, group dirty metal sheet. I'll make it a little bit bigger so you can see what I'm doing. So now we need to connect all these nodes to each other. So base color goes into base color, etc. But I have made this button for that there so that we don't have to do it by hand or manually, like so. We can use the same button for two mixes as well. Connect, and they'll connect together. Okay, doesn't really look good yet, and that's because we need the color ID connected and we need a vector input as well. So we can click on the first one, and if you have Node Wrangler installed, you can just click Control T, and then you'll have this setup added to the ID input. So a texture coordinate, a mapping, and an image texture. Then here we can select the color ID, that's this one. Nothing yet happens, and that's because we didn't pick an ID mask yet. So we need to pick a color, and that color will be masked out on the model. So click on the color here, select the color picker, and select it from your texture. So we still see nothing here. There's two reasons for that. First, we need to connect the UV to the vector so that Blender knows how to project on the model. So we did that here. But now everything is still the first color. And that's because we have the mix vector on 0. So we can go from 0 to 100. If I put it on 100, we mask out the materials. And we can go somewhere in between. So for example, 50. And then this will be half dirty metal sheet and half aluminium. But it's not what we want now, so let's put it on 100 again. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Like so. And now you can see this is the aluminium part and this is the dirty metal sheet part. There's a few things I'd like to explain. We can use scale to scale the material. So this will be the second material, the dirty metal sheet, and here we can scale the first one. It's a little bit hard to see because it's such a flat material, but that's the scaling of the aluminium part. We can also rotate. Let's do it on this one again. And we can also change the location. So if you don't like, for example, this spot here, there's a little bit of a strange spot to have there. You can just shift it like this, or maybe the Y. Now it's gone. Let me think. You can also scale everything, and you have to put something in between the UV here and the vector. That can be a mapping node, for example. You can use this one, but you'll also change the color ID. That's not something you want. So Shift D, connect it here, and now you can scale both materials. Let's see if we can show that. You see now it scales both of them, just the X in this case, but that's okay. Undo that. There's a lot more you can do. You can use the ambient occlusion and the curvature. We need cycles for especially the curvature, because it doesn't work in EV yet. Ambient occlusion does work, but it's not as good as in cycles. So for that, we'll need cycles as well. Another thing is that we also now have some extra groups. There's a blur group, a mix and max CTM, that's color to mask group. And we also have a normal mix group. So with this part is the same as the part we have here. We can take two normal textures and mix them together. We can either choose one or the other. If we have either one of them, we can make the strength a little bit lower or higher. And we can also mix between the first or the second one. So more of the second and more of the first one. Same as we do here. Okay, that's one. And then the color to mask is the same as we do with the ID here and the mask. So we use an ID and we mask a color out. In a later tutorial, I'll explain you why you have an extra node group for that. And then we also have a blur node, and with that we can blur textures. It's not a high quality blur, it's using a noise texture as blur, but it's okay. You can use it, for example, to blur your color ID or a part of a color ID. And that way, if you have a hard transition, like we would have here, I don't know if I can find that part for now. This part, maybe, no. Oh, we have something here. So we can make this transition a little bit softer, for example. If I put it in between, I think it should go here. Not sure about that, but there you go. And if you turn this up now, you see we have a softer blur in between those two. And you can see it's not a good transition, but it's working. So, and if you bake it out, it'll probably look a lot better. So this is a very basic explanation of what the Mix and Max add-on can do. Of course, you can do a lot more. I'll open another file to show you that. So here's the robot again with a more extended setup of Mix and Max. So let's have a look. I have used ambient occlusion to mask out some of the rust, so it's not everywhere, but just on some of the parts. It's also here in his body. There's some dirt here, but not on that part. I used a decal to make the holes here in his mouth. I used a blur node to blur this part here, for example. And some more things I did. I'll show you the nodes. The node setup here is pretty dense, but also I have a lot of materials here, and I even have a separate dirt texture here. I mix them together with mixed RGB nodes. I use, let me see here somewhere, I use the ambient occlusion here with a color ramp to change parts of the a new mask I made. So I have an extra mask part here. I should put that back. It might look pretty complicated, but I promise you, if you would do this without the Mix and Max nodes, it would look a lot more complicated, because each of these nodes have a lot inside and a lot is happening here. That makes it a lot simpler, like these connections here. This is an older version of Mix and Max, so I have an extra value node here for the scaling. That's not necessary anymore. So it's even simpler than that. It would look more something like this, for example. That's already looking a lot cleaner. Another thing is that in the Eevee preview, I get a purple view, and that's because I use more than 24 textures. And it's just a limitation of Blender, I believe. I'm not sure. It's either 24 textures or an X amount of principal PSDF nodes, but I just use one here, so that's not the case. So if I turn off, for example, one of these textures here, so if I just delete it, or this one, it should work again, because this is the 25th, I think. And there you go. You see, I already have the robot back. You can see ambient occlusion is working in Eevee, but it's just not working that well. It's changing when you change the camera or the viewport. Okay. So that's it. That's what we can do with Mix and Max. If you already get started with it, have fun playing with it. I think it's a joy. I have a lot more fun with Notes now, because it's just getting less complicated, as I said before. So have fun and have a nice day. Bye bye.